It's the Emit Blackwell Show, searching the web for the most creative, intriguing, and captivating people in the world.
Hello, and welcome once again to the Emit Blackwell Show. Before we begin, I would like to thank you all for listening, and don't forget to like, share, and subscribe to this podcast. This episode is brought to you by BookBannersEtc.com and Willow Kestrel Jewelry. If you enjoy the show and would like to become a sponsor, you can by contacting me directly at emmett.blackwell@gmail.com. On this episode, I have the multi-talented Anne Troy. Some of you may know her by her Twitter name, BrainsandSocks. She has written a fan fiction book on Wattpad called Muddy Waters. She writes and reads poetry and also sings. We are very excited to have Anne Troy on the show today. Hello, Anne. How are you doing today?
I'm doing very well, thanks. How are you?
I'm doing fantastic. I'm really excited to have you here on the show. Now, you write poetry, you write fan fiction and original fiction, and you also sing. I mean, you are multi-talented. When did you discover that you had these talents?
Well, probably mostly bit by bit, because my dad is a choir master, so I started singing as soon as I could walk, or speak for that matter. Hmm. But with writing, I started thinking up stories as soon as I became an avid reader, and I started writing them down as, I think, early as 9 years old. Of course, at that time, I wasn't very good yet, but I really stuck to it because thinking up stories and thinking up whole worlds and kind of disappearing in them is huge fun, especially for a child. And, well, fan fiction is just another part of it. I am a very avid Harry Potter fan. And was at that age too.
Oh yeah, I love Harry Potter.
And creating stories that were just slightly different were huge fun because I could work with something that was really, really part of my own heart and soul. But poetry, I actually thought I would never write. And I only started in college when my tutor encouraged me.
Hmm. So now, with the Harry Potter type stuff,
yeah,
I have a really difficult question. This might be something you might be able to answer, you might not be able to answer. But what house would you be in if you had the choice to be in a Hogwarts house?
Oh, Slytherin, most definitely.